Now, next speaker, Dr. Rupesh Ghyar, IIT Bombay.
Right, good morning all. So I'm Dr. Rupesh. I work at BETIC, Biomedical Engineering Technology Incubation Center. It is situated at IIT Bombay. I work with Professor B. Ravi. And the reason I'm here is we are trying to play a role being enablers for inclusive medical device innovation. So we've been doing it for some time. I didn't realize that was inclusive. Professor Ravi has been telling me that it has been inclusive for some time, and now I've been trying to understand that how we are actually trying to do that. I still am not very sure of the word inclusive, how it happens, but I'll try to portray what we are doing here in the center. So the idea was that can we bring doctors and engineers and entrepreneurs, everybody together for developing innovative medical devices for the Indian need right now. So it was idea of establishing a facility where such things can be done, develop devices, which is the core of it, medical devices, and then identify and support teams which we can do that, and also create facilities where such devices can be developed further also in a scientific manner. So what we did was understand what is the Indian medical device requirement. As you all know right now, a lot of medical devices are imported. Nearly about 80% of our medical devices in the country are imported, and most of you can identify these devices. So the cost of which comes down to a huge market share that has been imported. So here we thought that, is there anything that Indian companies are already doing? So we have hardly less than 300 licensed Indian medical device manufacturers. So that is one worry. We do have 800 manufacturers in medical devices. However, we have only 300, about less than 300, which are licensed manufacturers. So the regulations in the country, the way it is, and the people who are getting approvals for quality manufacturing is still an issue. So we thought that maybe that is one area. And also, if you see, the turnover of few of these companies, only few of them have a large turnover. So again, they are doing maybe local manufacturing and local distribution for low value items. So that is another area that was a worry. So if we put it into perspective, total overall what we understood, the overall clinical need or the pull for medical device innovation can be broadly classified as the devices have to be affordable, available, they have to be high quality, reliable, local needs. But then we also realize that we are not far away from the rest of the world. We do have some advantages, and that is technology. So that's where we are saying, can technology enable, and can we be the enablers for using these technologies for having that leapfrog? So here, as you can see, Indians, we are supposed to be good at IT, software, imaging, sensors. We have a good hold on 3D printing, CAD CAM. So that is a good asset, what we have. And we do have some good engineering base with more than 10 million engineers coming every year, and they from various domain. But what is needed is people who can integrate this, or people who can put them together, because medical devices are more based on interdisciplinary work. It's not a single device, it's just mechanical engineering or it's just electronics engineering. They are kind of integrated all together, and we have huge walls between these departments who are not talking to each other. Especially electronics and software play a major role in the upcoming medical devices. So what we have created is now a facility, small facility at IIT Bombay. It's more like a small shed where you can see that we have a small idea room where innovators come over here. Innovators who want to become entrepreneurs, we filter them and we put them in these rooms where they bring their ideas to reality. That first reality happens here. They make their first proof of concept. That is the part where it happens. We have a CAD CAM room where CAD and imaging is done. We also have an electronics new room which has come up for electronics prototyping, and a mechanical prototyping and testing room. But if you see, relatively it's a small unit. We have a few number of people who are working closely on this one. So that's about the facility, the equipment or whatever place we have. But this is about the process. So I would like to spend maybe a little more concentration on this, maybe focus on this. So we have been working on medical device innovation for more than now 10 to 15 years. And in small bits in various things, but we have come up with some process which seems to be working. So the idea is that can we define it very well, the problem, what is the need, then develop the solutions, and each of them have different players who can play in that role, and then deliver it back and then deploy it. So the idea is, again, as Dr. Chidambaram said earlier and from everybody, it's not just creating some kind of a research paper or a patent, or that falls along. Those are byproducts. The idea is that how do we have a sustainable mechanism of deploying the innovation that was designed for such needs? So it has to walk through all these cycles. And I'll just put through that. Each of them we further divide it, and we realize that there is a pattern for that. So once you have a good team, which is collaboration integrated with doctors, engineers have to leave their comfort zone, go to surgeries, meet doctors, understand the problems, live the problems, and then start building the designs and apply their skills to these. And not just that, stop at that, but that one proof of concept is one part, but take it all the way further, manufacture, develop the testing plans and regulations. So even if you just don't stop at that, you have to even go further, do a IPR management, do a business plan. Either you start a company or you pass on to an Indian manufacturer, enable the manufacturer of an high-end technology or that innovation to be manufactured at scale. So there are two ways that we say, if you are buying part of this, you try to solve a problem, develop a device, make sure that it reaches the people it was designed for, not just keep it in a lab or something. So I'll just quickly give you that. We thought that we should have 300 ideas, maybe 75 will come to some prototype stage, 20 would be prototypes, and maybe 12 successful devices. So how do we started doing that? We started interacting with a lot of clinicians, doctors, all from various domains, as you can see. These are photos from our lab. So if, on an average, we have two doctors or experts coming to our lab, interacting, kind of giving their needs. So in last 2.5 years, 3 years, we have had about 50 to 100 clinicians whom we have been interacting. We also go and visit hospitals to understand the scenario more in detail, live the problems. So our engineers go into hospital settings and surgeries. And not just that, so the outcome what we have done in last 3 years is that we have developed devices which have gone to industry. Somebody has started a company, the innovators have started company, or it has gone to hospital, or it has been licensed. So if you see the domain of each of them, surgical instruments, rehabilitation, screening devices, it's huge. As in that's spread across the spectrum. And I'll just take three cases which you have seen outside, the posters are there. The first one being the laparoscopic surgery instrument. So surgeons were doing the surgery because it is now minimal invasive. You don't have a large port open. You have small instruments which go through small holes. But the problem is you have lost your surgery skills because you don't have your wrists inside. So you're operating like this. And being India, we have different kind of problem. The surgeon is not doing one or two surgeries per day. He's doing multiple such surgeries. So these surgeons are facing different kinds of problem. So the instruments which are designed for European or other kind of population, the surgeons, are not suiting here. So we have developed now a multi-degree of freedom device, a surgical instrument, a laparoscopic instrument, which is not just straight, but at the end, it has an effector which turns and rotates. So from outside, you can control. If you say there's no electronics involved in this. So we have tried to keep it simple and cost effective. And now there is a manufacturer from Mumbai who has licensed this technology, who has more than 15,000 distribution channel networks throughout India, that he's actually going to take this and manufacture in mass and produce it further. A lot of manufacturing expertise has gone to fit something like that in 10 mm of rod. So the second example I would put is that the primary clinicians or the primary health workers trying to get the heart diagnosis, blood pressure measurements, ASHA workers, they take the first line of first parameters. However, one key element, the stethoscope, has been neglected because a trained doctor has to remember more than 100 sounds of heart and lungs. And 2.8 million people in India die because of heart and lung diseases. And that's a huge number. But the most important tool, the stethoscope, which gives you sound, is kind of not really being used to its full potential because you need a lot of expertise, learning curve is high, you have to have that kind of quality stethoscope, and that come at a very expensive price. There are ECGs, EKGs, but they monitor electrical activity. There's nothing to monitor the sound and also the sound of lungs. So wheezes, crackles, murmurs, all these can be the primary indicators which can be identified. Those selected few people from that rural places or other low resource setting places can be brought to higher places where we have very dangerous ratio of the expert cardiologist to the patients. So we are trying to see if not everybody should be brought to the city, or the city doctors do not want to go there. Maybe the information can transfer. So what we have come up is a stethoscope. So that's the model, and now it has been placed. So what it does is you take any stethoscope, it converts it into a digital stethoscope. So what with that you can do is the primary setting person can actually hear an amplified noise-free sound of the heart or lung, which can also be recorded and transmitted to a place where there is an expert available. So that's the model we have created, and we have got very good results now. But we are now further taking and trying to see if just that is not enough, but we need to create a whole ecosystem around it so that it reaches the people it was designed for. So the last example I would say is a lot has been spoken about Jaipur foot. So we have an NGO in Mumbai which is providing Jaipur foot leg to amputees, and what we have done is that that place has two or three technicians who is manufacturing. So if an amputee comes in the morning 8 or 9 o'clock, by the end of the day one or two legs are manufactured and they get it. In case the amputee comes at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, because the process takes about 6 to 8 hours, he has to wait overnight in a place like Mumbai where he's come from a rural place to get that leg, and that itself is a logistic problem. Then there is a lot of involvement of plaster of Paris measurement. It's a humid day, plaster of Paris may not dry in that particular time frame. So what we have come up is using technology like scanning and 3D printing, we take few measurements in that setting. Those, say if it's a rural setting, few measurements are taken, those are just SMS, and a server creates the 3D model of the patient's socket, which is either machined or printed, and then that socket can go to the patient. So that reduces the time frame to some 2 hours or 3 hours right now. We've just fitted that and the patient was able to walk. Again, the kind of terrains we have in the country like India are different. So that was a good example where we could actually showcase this is possible, that the 3D printed socket was able to be given to a patient. Don't worry, the red shirt guy is a physiotherapist who's walking nearby. So we have not just put the patient in a danger zone. So we do have a trained person who is helping him get trained into that. So I'll just move on to the second part, that's last part. So these innovators are getting quite a lot of recognition. They have been identified as people who have been trying to create some impact, and a lot of people are trying to see that. But we are not just stopping here. So there is a place where you can do that. There are processes and there are devices. So in last 2.5 years, we have followed around 300 needs have been identified. Proof of concepts for 75 devices have been developed, 25 patents, and the last part, we have come up with 12 devices which have either gone to an industry or it has been formed as a license or it has been given to an NGO to take it all the way forward. So we have created an ecosystem where hospitals, government, industry, all are part of this medical device innovation. So organizations at that scale, and they have different roles of regulations, clinical needs, manufacturing, and also identifying the next generation of innovators who can take it all the way, and entrepreneurs also. But also the kind of people who play a role, if you just take the stethoscope, there are doctors who are involved in development, nurses, primary clinicians, physicians, in the development software, mechanical engineers, designers, testing engineers, delivery-wise, clinical, regulatory, all these people are involved to deploy to either a primary healthcare, hospital, NGO, entrepreneur, and there's a company which is going to be formed for this device so that it reaches the people it was designed for. So to conclude, I would say that we're trying to develop and make in India medical device innovation, understanding our needs. And we do have a good ecosystem, but pilot manufacturing, how do you make 20 of these devices so that a lot of people can try and test it, is still a problem for us. We're still trying to do a vendor-based thing. And the opportunity is high, and we have a small window of 5 years before different companies come in this market and start making such devices at a low cost in our own setting with the Make in India initiative. So thank you very much.